Hello everyone. Recently, CBSE has changed the question paper pattern for the board exam 2021. They have introduced a new pattern of question called as case study based question. So in today's video, I am going to do a case study based question from the chapter real numbers. So we know that here you can see a flowchart. We know that natural numbers are the numbers, counting numbers, and they start from 1, 2, 3, etc. Then comes whole numbers. Whole numbers, smallest whole number is 0 and start from 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. After that, we have integers. So integers, we have both the positive numbers as well as negative numbers, and 0, it together forms integers. So you can see minus 10, 0, minus 24, minus 3, when positive numbers, negative numbers and 0 together forms integers. Then comes rational numbers. Rational numbers, you can say that the numbers which can be written in the form of P by Q, they are called as rational numbers. Q should not be equal to 0 and P and Q are integers. So this minus 1 is an integer because I can write minus 1 as minus 1 by 1 again. 25 is an integer because I can write 25 as 25 by 1. Then 0.75 is also an integer because I can write it as 75 by 100. So all these are integers. Then comes a separate group of numbers which is called as irrational numbers. Irrational numbers are those numbers which cannot be written in the form of P by Q. For example, root 2, root 3, root 5, pi, all these are examples for irrational numbers. Again, rational numbers are terminating decimal or non-terminating recurring decimals, and irrational numbers are non-terminating non-recurring decimals. So this, all these numbers will come under one family which is called as real numbers. So they have given here, real numbers are the numbers which include both rational and irrational numbers. Rational numbers are the numbers which can be written in the form of P by Q, where P and Q are integers and Q not equal to 0. And irrational numbers are those numbers which cannot be expressed as a ratio of two integers. Now let's see the questions and solve that. Every rational number is, the options are natural number, whole number, an integer and a real number. So from the flowchart we can make out that every rational number is a real number. Because if I take the rational number minus 25, minus 25 is a rational number, it is not a whole number, it is not a natural number, but we can say that it is, all this rational numbers comes under one family called as real number. Again, next one, product of two irrational number is always rational, always irrational, always integer, sometimes rational and sometimes irrational. So the correct option is you take any two irrational number, root 2 into root 3. These both are irrational numbers. So if I multiply it, I'll get root 6. So it is irrational. But if I take root 5 into root 5, both are irrational. I'm getting root 25. Root 25 is 5. That is rational. So it is sometimes rational and sometimes irrational. So product of two rational numbers is sometimes rational and sometimes irrational. Third question, between two rational numbers, there is no rational number, there is exactly one rational number, there are infinitely many irrational number and there is no irrational number. So the answer is there are infinitely many irrational number. Between two rational number, you can find infinitely many irrational number as well as you can find many infinitely many rational numbers. For example, if I take two rational numbers, say 2 and 3, I can find many infinite irrational numbers, say 2.1, 2.2, 2.3, 2.4. Infinite number of rational numbers I can find as well as infinite number of irrational numbers. For example, 2.101, 001, 000, etc. Again, 2.11. 2, again 11, 1112, etc. So like this infinite number of irrational number I can find between two rational numbers. Now the next one, sum of rational and irrational number is. So sum of a rational and irrational number is, for example, 2 is a rational number, root 3 is a rational number. So 2 plus root 3, we cannot add this, one is rational, other is irrational. So it will be always irrational. Sum of a rational and irrational number is always irrational. Again, which of the following is an irrational number? You can see here 3.14, 3.14, 1414, etc. 3.14444, etc. 3.14, 114, again 1114, etc. So this I can write 3.14 bar because 14 is repeating. This I can write 3.1 bar over 4 because only 4 is repeating. And we know that rational numbers will be either terminating decimal or non-terminating repeating decimals. Rational numbers are terminating decimal or non-terminating repeating decimal. So we can see here this is a terminating decimal and these two are non-terminating, but it is repeating. In the first case 14 is repeating, in the second case only 4 is repeating. So these all the three are rational numbers, and this one irrational number is always non-terminating, non-repeating decimal. Here we can see 14 is not repeating, it is appearing in a special pattern, so that number is called as irrational number. So the correct answer is 3.141141114, etc. So in today's video we have seen a case study based question from the chapter real numbers. Thank you for watching my video.